Greetings, fellow Africans. Today I want to discuss and congratulate the people of Zambia for changing the image of Africa. You know, Africa, many people think that in Africa there's no democracy. And we think that democracy maybe is maybe just only election. We have seen in many parts of Africa that after election there is a conflict. But Zambia has demonstrated that Africa, that we Africans, we are good people. We can handle our things. We can handle this, what we call democracy, and we can transfer the power from one party to another party peacefully. If you look what people said about Africa, about democracy, it seems like Africa, we don't have a democracy. Of course, democracy differ because the democracy of United States of America cannot be the same as the democracy of Rwanda, or democracy of Uganda, or democracy of Kenya, because even our culture is so different. But we Africans, sometimes we force the democracy to be the same. The democracy will differ because of, according to the environment. But what Zambian people has been doing and done is something that is so amazing, and we must congratulate the people of Zambia for changing the power peacefully. Not only happening in Zambia, last year we have seen what happening in Malawi when Dr. Chakwera came into power. So this is what we need to see, the image of Africa. Sometimes we, the people of Africa, we don't have enough time, enough space in the public to speak our good things. Always we speak about negative. So this is the time to tell the people that forget about the last. Of course, yes, we have some problems, but also we have good things. And what is happening in Zambia is something that must be congratulated by every African. And what Mr. Lungu has been doing is very, very, very fantastic. So he agreed that, first he disagreed with the election result, but at the end, he agreed that this election is free and fair, and he accepted the defeat. So this is what we want to see, not only in Zambia, but all of the continent of Africa. You know, sometimes this conflict is something that brings us behind of our development. When, just imagine what's happening if there's a conflict now in Zambia. What they have been doing with Dr. Edgar Lungu for maybe 5 years will be lost within a short time. We use a lot of money. We take a loan from China, from other parts of the world to build our infrastructure. But when it comes in conflict, those all infrastructure will be bombed or destructed within a short time. So you see how this conflict sometimes bring African in backward. So what Zambian people have been doing is something that is good and must be congratulated, because we need peace in Africa. Our people need development. You know, if you read the history of Africa, Africa, we are not a fighter. Africa, we are peaceful people. That's why even when the European come to Africa, we welcome them. Our ancestors welcome them. That's it. You are welcome to our motherland, Africa, the best land of Africa. But what's happening is another issue. But all in all, our people, our African people, love peace. We love peace, and we live in peaceful. We live as a family, and this is what's happening to Zambia. So we congratulate all people of Zambia, the president-elect, Mr. Hakainde Hichilema. Of course, Mr. Hakainde has the challenges because we have heard and seen that Zambia has a lot of debt from China government. So this is the main thing that Mr. Hakainde Hichilema is supposed to solve this problem. Also, the people of Zambia have their own problem. They want to solve their problem. That's why they decided to take down Mr. Edgar Lungu and raise up Mr. Hakainde Hichilema, so that you know that Mr. Hakainde can change their life, the condition of the people can bring development in Zambia, and some of issues that is difficult can be solved. And that is what the people of Zambia are expecting. Not only Zambian people, but African people in and in the diaspora expecting much from Mr. Hakainde Hichilema. So that is what I want to share to you on, and say that what Zambia has been doing is something that changed the image of Africa in the front of the world. This is what we need to hear and to see. And all African leader must learn, must accept. If you are in power and another political party has been elected, so we have to agree, because our aim is to build our continent or our country. So all in all, we are challenging each other with the policies, so that how we can lead our country or our continent. That is the aim. So no need to fight, no need to have a conflict in the country or in the continent, because when we have this conflict, it means we left the other thing and we engage in conflict. We use a lot of time in conflict. That's not what we don't need in our continent. We need peace, we need development, and we need to work together as a continent. Thank you for watching.